where everyone thinks, oh, Alex Bell is gonna lose, oh, blah, blah, blah. I come out on top. I beat him in the Hell in a Cell, which no one saw coming. You aren't here working hard for your paychecks. You aren't here entertaining fans across the globe. You aren't here busting your ass with next generation talent.
And now leave from the Global Ring Center. Sponsored by Dragon Ball Care, Evolve Wrestling Entertainment presents Immortal Four.
Welcome everybody to the Global Ring Center, where we have Immortal 4. This is just a few of the matches we will see tonight. Some of the few matches that I'm very excited for personally. We've also got an official sponsor here from Dragon Ball K. Watch Goku as he goes up against new and old faces with new and old friends with new strength and power in the new generation of Dragon Ball, created on Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 on PlayStation 5 via Fierce 9. And now, making his way to the ring, weighing in at about 162 pounds, Blue Golden Winged Angel, Hendrick Newman. Huh? Why is he here? Last time we saw him was at No Mercy, and of course, No Mercy isn't active at this current time. Due to reasons, I don't actually know. No one knows. It's just all the director's decision. We're trying to get loads of things sorted out of this. Why is he here, Immortal? I didn't even know. What do you possibly want? He's not put in the show. It's just a disaster written all over it. Really? You thought you could have the Immortal without me? The founder of Evolved Wrestling Entertainment. I am the only reason that you're here, basically. You would be here getting along with your shitty 9-to-5s if I wasn't alive. You realize that, right? You wouldn't have all the stars at your disposal to tweet about, to hate on, to love, if I wasn't here. So with that, I hear you all booing. I demand a bit of respect. You know, I'm actually sorry for once in my life for you guys, because you won't be able to, well, witness the spectacle of me wrestling in Japan. And now, isn't that just a wasted opportunity? Of course, I've been here before, and you all know that I'm capable of putting on, well, 5-star bangers, left, right, and centre, same night, every day, no matter where I am. I could be in a parking lot with like 3 people, and I'd put on a straight banger if I wanted to. You know, I did come here in wrestling gear, because I wanted to fight for the world title, I'm going to be honest with you. You know, a man of my calibre, and whatever's going on with No Mercy right now, I deserve a title shot, right? At the world title. We all know this. I should be the world champion, not some Smurf reject. But that's why I came out of my gear. Andy Carlos. You know what I want. So give it to me.
What? No. What is going on here in Immortal right now? Bringing it out to
wrong, huh? What's wrong? Now that I'm here, you wanna freeze up? I've been watching you. I have, and I have seen you just copyright my character. I mean, I know people love me, you know. I know that I'm probably, no, I'm not probably, I am the best thing in wrestling, let's be honest. But damn, to just copy my whole character and name it yourself? You're so damn lucky, kid. You're so damn lucky that I haven't sued your ass yet. You know, it's fine. It's fine. You want a world title match? Do you? Well, I've seen this little video that's been roaming around the internet. As it does. And you played a little video game. You went at AEW and you owned the whole stuff. That's fine. But it's the stuff that you said in the video that pissed me off. Yeah? I'm a ripoff you? But we both know that that isn't true. You wanna say something? You wanna? You was running your mouth a lot before I came out. Why are you here? Why? You know what? You, of all people, know me. Right? Of course you have. I mean, clearly you've watched me enough to copy my entire persona, right? So I'll cut you some slack here, right? You are alright in the ring. Like, not better than me, obviously, but probably better than a lot of WWE and AEW guys that I've seen come in and out of the business. So I can at least respect you in-ring. And I've always wanted to beat the ever-living shit out of you for stealing everything I've done and acted like it's your own. Come on, the golden winged angel. Look at your merch. Look at your t-shirt. Man, what is that? That is almost genuinely my design. I could claim that. GWA. I'm just that good. What is this, man? Can't you just be original? You know, Max, you're talking about me and stuff, about how we're similar. No. I'm not talking about how we're similar. I'm talking about how you flat out copyrighted me, man. Fine, whatever you want to think. But I'm going to quote someone here. And you'll know him very well. I know him. Not as well as you, but still. You know, Max, you talk a lot of shit for a less famous Miz. Wow. Well done, dude. You successfully copied another wrestler who's much more famous than you, and he doesn't even wrestle. Is this your career? Is this what you're made of? Copying others? Really? Show some bite! Show me I'm wrong! Huh? Anyway, back to my original point. I have always wanted to get in the ring with you, not for a good match, right? I wanted to get in the ring with you to beat the shit out of you for copying my entire personality. So, you want a world title match? I've got a world title, which is more prestigious than his entire company. We're in the middle of Tokyo. I'm ready to fight. You look like you're ready to fight. You came out in your gear. So, let's have it. Let's have an AEW world title match in the middle of the Global Ring Center right now. Right fucking now. You know? This just gives... this just... You realise this just adds another title to my resume, right? Nah, shut up. I don't want to hear you stuttering. I just want to hear a yes or a no. Yeah, I accept. I accept it. I won the match right now. Get a damn ref in here.
What? Okay, so we're now having an unregistered match for the AEW World Heavyweight Championship in the middle of Tokyo in Immortal 4. Could there be a better way to start off this goddamn pay-per-view? And we're off! Some may say this is a dream match come to life. Don't know for sure, it definitely is for one person in that ring, and that person has just got MJF in a roll-up. Here we go, wait, no! MJF counters it! This could be a giant upset at the beginning of the show, enough of a roll-up, what the hell? And I kick out. Hayden now on the middle rope, but MJF kicks the turnbuckle, making him lose his balance and falls. And now he's going to go for a lock-up. Alabama slam, maybe not! Oh my god! Reversal into a Canadian destroyer! A great reversal, but you've got to keep your eyes on the devil at all times. Or else this will happen. MJF has just taken complete control of this match. At least he's trying to off the ropes now. And a big boot via Maxwell Jacob Freeman and a spear! Really showing why he is the AEW World Heavyweight Champion right now. I know we said that you can't keep your eyes off the devil, but you cannot keep your eyes off the Golden Winged Angel either. And wait a minute, what is this? A camel clutch submission hold put in on MJF, but he's able to get an elbow out and trip him into the ropes. No matter if you love him or hate him, you've just got to respect the in-ring awareness from MJF as he now pops in some sort of leveraged armbar. This may not win the match as of right now, but this is going to soften Hayden up for the salt of the earth. Oh my god! Giant knee to the cheek of MJF, but he kicks out at one. Back and forth, 50-50. These two with this unplanned match have just blown the non-existent roof off this place, and he does a cartwheel and steps on MJF's chest. It's a battle of the biggest egos. It's the battle of two of the greatest in-ring performers we've seen to this day. It's the battle of the GWA versus MJF. As of right now, MJF's title reign is looking to be in jeopardy as he rolls to the outside of the ring but trips Hayden up. Falling on the apron, the hardest part of the ring, that is going to leave a bruise tomorrow if it hasn't right now. And I think MJF knows this. This is, he's targeting specific spots. Hold on, what's he going for here? I guess as the champion, he chose the match type, whatever it may be. Wait a minute, the Dynamite Diamond Ring! Across the cheek of the Golden Winged Angel! That might have just knocked him the hell out! And just from that display, looking at the evidence, MJF pulled the Dynamite Diamond Ring out from under the ring. He had this match planned! And a kick out from the past, the present, and the future of professional wrestling. Does this mean that MJF actually knew about Hayden coming down to run his mouth, wanting to be added to the world title match? One can only assume. A big knee gone wrong, MJF slow to recover, now he's being walked like a dog to the ropes. What is the Golden Winged Angel got in plan here? Running rope to rope, big kick, and a stomp! Into the cover quickly to try and win the AEW World Championship, and that will only be a two. As you can see, the crowd is very 50-50 on this match that no one even saw coming. But what I've also actually noticed around the back of the crowd, people have actually brought the country's flags and wore face paint. If I had to assume, it was probably to get ready for the World Cup final, which is taking place tonight. Supergroup versus Cage in a big boot via MJF. Honestly, with these two, if you think of these two in a ring, you think of a lot of scummy tactics and, well, unorthodox tactics that people don't really agree on. The only dirty, really, thing we've seen is the Dynamite Diamond Ring, and of course this match is still going on because, well, it's a no disqualification match. I'm going to guess anyway. MJF is the champion. EWE rules. You get to pick the match type. And also, to give respects to MJF, he is fighting not even in proper wrestling gear. He's fighting in, like, what, suit pants? And he's keeping up with, well, one of the pillars of this company. Of course, he is a pillar of AEW as well, and... wait a minute. Oh, no. MJF setting up for the Heat Seeker. I think it's game over now. MJF looking to claw in this win and retain the title. Saudi Earth locked in on that arm that was taking serious damage from that bridging armbar last time, a few minutes ago. Center of the ring, there is no with the crew, even if there wasn't no DQ. Wait a minute, the Golden Winged Angel head scissors out of it. Satan's kiss! Satan's kiss! Finishing maneuver by the Golden Winged Angel! The fans from all across the globe who have came here right now in the Global Ring Center to witness, well, not even to witness this match, nobody knew it was going to happen. But they are letting their opinions know by clapping. And MJF, he's holding the trunks down, but it's still a kick out. Dark's under the clothesline. Oh, this is the perfect setup. Was looking for Saiyan's kiss. Sonya! Sonya solution. Logs in the bridging over. And he's gonna happen, and it's a tap out. Tapping out is the Golden Wind Angel in the morning. What a match, and this will be it for the first kind of part of the World War. Wait a minute, Mr. Gold in the Bank, Justin Forbes, just came sprinting down. Wait, Justin Forbes, he's catching him. Gold in the Bank. The Gold in the Bank, it states that you can cash in on any title as long as the pay-per-view is active in EWE Battle Paradise. Justin Ford taking his opportunity. He could be the new AEW World Heavyweight Champion. And the second. Justin Ford setting up for possibly the third and final Plan in Paradise. MJF reverse super kick. I think he's just realised what the hell is happening. And wait a minute, so on the earth. The man with a plan, Justin Ford, immediately out of that one. As you'd expect. He's not called the man with a plan for nothing. He has a plan for every situation he's in, every maneuver, you know. And wait a minute, MJF, Dynamite Diamond Ring, Justin Ford ducks under him. And now he stalks the AEW World Champion with a roll-up. Only a two. However, Ford isn't going to give up that easily. Clothesline turned into a German. Spike on the head. Hold on a minute. What is the hardcore champion Kyle Reyes getting up to, going onto the apron, shouting at MJF, who takes a punch at the back of the head? And now these two extends. Oh, Kyle Reyes getting involved. No, he wants to help his teacher out and everything. But Kyle really, really should be looking to be training and getting some extra planning in for his TLC match, where he will be putting the Hardcore Championship on the line against Alpha Star and Jackson Hart. And wait a minute, so on the earth. It is locked in really well. But Ford, he never wants to tap out to a submission, no matter how bad of a condition he's in. Kyle shouting some words to advice to his teacher. Ford just trying to concentrate, trying to think of a way how he can get out of this submission maneuver. And he flips out with a head scissors once again. Ford, this probably hasn't gone the way how he has wanted. It is, wait a minute, saw the earth in on MJF. Look at the panic. But oh, I think Ford has genuinely just accidentally taught MJF how to get out of his own submission. Oh, Kyle Reyes. I mean, if you teach someone without accidentally teaching them, I guess that just means you're a really, really fucking good teacher. However, I guess the student doesn't paint the teacher. Kyle Reyes getting involved with a match that isn't even his business. And after all this talk, talking about how he's changed, about how he's better, about how he won't be dirty, I'm starting to have doubts, starting to have second thoughts about all of this. And Ford looking to lock in another soul of the earth. JF panicking again. Ford is looking to ground Maxwell Jacob Freeman to this canvas, making it hard for him to roll out and hit the head scissors, but he's managed anyway. That is good, I was going to say good effort, but he's gotten further than an effort. I think we're looking for an ending here. Here we go. Maxwell Jacob Freeman with the heat seeker. A quick jab to Kyle Rise as he gets in the ring. Saudi Earth from the Hardcore Champion. Now this is going to have great impacts on the match later on tonight. A tactical tap out, I'm sure. However, thinking about it, as much as it's going to have impacts on the match for Kyle Rise later tonight, it might have negative impacts for MJF as Justin Ford is recovered. MJF making sure that Kyle Rise is down. Planning Pano, reverse receiver kick. MJF now. Soulbound with the other hand, Soul of the Earth, he's going to look to tap out Justin Ford. He's wrenching on it, but let's go. I think he knows that Ford isn't going to tap. Cover now. Two in one, none.
The winner of this match, and still
AEW World Heavyweight Champion, MJF. Two unplanned matches, unexpected matches, and two wins for Maxwell Jacob Friedman.
This ain't fucking over. I'll see you next week, yeah? Don't bother fucking saying that you won't appear. I'll fucking force you to come to the arena. Kyle, enough. Just go. Just fucking go. We need to get prepared for your match. Yeah, alright. I'm just letting Maxi know. Yeah, whatever. We're going.
I think that means in the opening episode of Season 5 EWE, we're going to see MJF again? Possibly, I don't know.